It was nothing short of amazing. Miracles for all to see. Impossible to ignore. Why, people from all around Galilee, up from Jerusalem, across the Jordan, all of Judea would come pressing in, hoping it was real. Some suspecting it's a trick. But who could deny? The blind could see. The deaf could hear. Lame could walk. Dead were raised. Good news preached to all. But listen to this. Jesus forgives sin. Yes, he does. Oh, you didn't see it. The chief priest caught a harlot right in the act. How did they do that? They paraded their prize through the crowd, slung her to the ground as a trophy to their righteous indignation, hoping to trap Jesus into contradicting Moses. The law tells us to stone this sinner. What do you say, Jesus? Let any one of you who is without sin cast the first stone. Ha! They were shocked, stunned, humiliated. They dropped their stones and left as Jesus simply said, "You are forgiven. Go and sin no more." Well, who is this man who could forgive sins? That was the question on everyone's mind. One day, when the crowds had gathered, waiting, hoping Jesus was going to do something, a miracle, anything, he called out his disciples and Simon. I call you Peter. And then he said this, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are the meek, you will inherit the earth. Blessed are you who mourn, you will be comforted. Blessed are you who hunger and thirst for righteousness. You will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, the pure of heart, and the peacemakers. You will be known as the children of God. You are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world. Let your light shine, that many will see your good works and glorify your God. You have heard it said long ago to love your neighbors, and so you should. But I tell you, love your enemies, pray for those who persecute you, forgive, and you will be forgiven. Store up your treasures in heaven, where neither rust nor moth nor thieves can destroy. Where your treasure is, there your heart is also. Give, and it will be given unto you. Ask, and you will receive. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and doors will be opened to you." Well, no wonder. Everywhere we went, the people anxious to hear, to see, to touch just a hem of his garment. But nothing like one wonderful Sunday. We were on our way to Jerusalem to celebrate the feast. Thousands were already with us. Thousands come rushing out from the city to greet us. It was unbelievable. The children were running and playing. People were singing and dancing. And then they started to take their coats off and lay them on the street in front of Jesus. While they were cutting down palm branches, they were waving them in the air, and all of them were shouting, "Hosanna!